and he believed this is a good tactic for that, and credit to him. We done it. He's planning for Argentina, where we are supposed at least to be 50-50, if not us sitting back a little bit more, that he's going to change the system and he's going to play maybe Modric in a hole, like behind the striker.
Do you feel there's a lot more to come from Croatia? I mean, they didn't need to do an awful lot more this evening than they did.
Yeah, no, I think they'll have to up their game, which they will do. When you're up against better teams like Argentina, it'll just come natural to them. They'll still be pleased tonight, a job done, but they'll need improvement, of course, against a really good Argentina team.
Yeah, I was really disappointed in the first half with certainly Nigeria, with Croatia as well a little bit, but they will get better. And we saw when the subs came on and they're a class act. They've just got their tactics. First half were a little bit too forward thinking, and they didn't suck up Nigeria out enough. But they're a good side.
Fair enough. Nigeria was bad, but look, this was the first game of the World Cup. We didn't have any trouble whatsoever. Scored two goals.
Yeah, yeah.
Should have scored a third one. They done nothing. Clean sheet. And to be fair, from these 3 or 4 days of the World Cup, we didn't impress. But who impressed?
Yeah.
France didn't impress. Yeah. Denmark didn't impress. Uruguay didn't. Only Russia with the result 5-0. All the rest. So we done well. Brilliant stuff.
First games are only about winning, aren't they? You know, you don't want to leave all your best form here. It's just about winning and getting better.
And that's the strength of our side. You know, look, we won the first game against Nigeria, who at least on paper are okay side. And that shows how strong we are. We won 2-0 without any problems, and still we are talking like, Croatia didn't show a lot.
They didn't even break sweats tonight.
That's good.
That easy for them.
And it's good to see that a penalty decision could be made without VAR. What we mean by that is it would have been automatically checked, but the referee got it absolutely spot on. There is some wrestling going on from Ekong on Mandzukic.
Well, Ekong didn't have enough hugs at half-time, so he thought he'd have one on Mandzukic there. What is he doing there? The referee's standing 5 yards away. I mean, I'm all for touch tight, but he's all over him. A definite penalty and a yellow card.
I'm pleased he got punished. Lazy defending, cheating. I don't understand why these players don't want to defend properly. It's just a form of cheating, and I'm glad they got punished for it.
Yep, and Modric put the penalty away after the goal in the first half. We never saw from Nigeria what we hoped, even in those glimpses that we saw in the second half at Wembley, which just maybe suggested what we might get tonight.
Yeah, I mean, Roy said while we were watching the game, he said it's like a friendly, it's like a practice match. They won't get anything from this. They weren't even, and even in the end, I mean, Moses was keeping the ball down near the corner flag. He was 2-0 down. And it was just a bizarre performance for me. No effort gone into or endeavour to try and get any points out of that.
I think the reason with the question mark... I also have a question mark about our performance. I think the biggest reason for that, because the both goals didn't come from our great moves. They both goals because the Nigerian players were sloppy. Two set pieces, and it wasn't even a header or whatever. It was like too sloppy from them.
Yeah.
It means the next game against Argentina on Thursday... There's a chance to nail down the last 16 place already in game two.
Yeah, to be fair, but considering with the greatest respect to Iceland, if we get a point against Argentina, then with the win against Iceland, we are top of the group.
You're very positive.
Of course I'm positive. Of course I'm positive. I play for good clubs, always positive, not
good attitude to have. No, still tough game to head from. And us, it rolls off the tongue. Just get a draw against Argentina, beat Iceland. If the game was as simple as that, it'd be great. But no, I think tough few weeks coming up still for Croatia. I think Argentina would beat them.
Yep, OK, good start nevertheless. We will hear from Gareth Southgate next as England get ready to start their World Cup campaign on Monday in Volgograd. And to win a chance to see them in action this autumn and a good chunk of cash, have a watch of this. Here's another chance to make it a glorious summer. To kick things off, we're giving away a massive £40,000 in tax-free cash.